Hello guys, I heard you wanna create a modded map for the Senders, right? So here's a 5-minute tutorial to be successful creating your first map. Step 1. Download the essentials. Unity, the same version as the game. Custom map bundle with basic assets, like ramps for your map. And the mod tool which enables easy exporting maps for the Senders. Step 2. Install and prepare Unity. Let's install Unity as every other software, just smashing that next button until it's done. Now we can open Unity for the first time. Create a new 3D project, put the name on it, and click create. Kill the main camera and also kill every scene in your project except the one you're gonna use. Let's prepare the software by importing the mod tool and the custom map bundle. Step 3. Understanding the user interface. Hierarchy is where all the elements of your map will be listed. Lightning is where the options for lightning will be. Project is where all your imported assets will be. Inspector is where all the options of your selected object or tool will be. Mod exporter is for... wait. Click Tools, Mod Tool and Export Mod, and then drag the export window to the right corner and boom! Export shortcut achieved. So mod exporter is where we're gonna set everything needed to export our map for the Senders. Step 4. Understanding the tools. I'm just going to show you the essential tools we're gonna need to make our map. So the object tools. 2 for moving. 3 for rotating. 4 for scaling. 6 for supreme fog tool. And now for the terrain tools. F1 to raise and lower. F2 for height painting. F3 to smooth height. F4 to paint texture. F5 to paint trees. F6 to paint details like grass and flowers. And the last one is the terrain settings. And the most important one, if you like this content, please hit the like button too and subscribe to the channel if you like my content. Thank you! Step 5. Camera movement. So, right click for pivot, alt plus left click for orbit, wheel mouse or alt plus right click for back and forth, middle mouse button for vertical movement, arrows for horizontal, and add shift to previous for faster movement. Step 6. Now you can start making your own map. It's essential to put a start line and a finish line. If you imported the custom map bundle, you will have a prefabs for both of them, including checkpoints either if you wanna put some in your own map. So at some point you might wanna test your map and make sure everything's okay. So instead of using mod.io as everybody does for some reason I really don't know, I'm gonna explain a better solution. Step 7. Local testing your map. While we are developing the map, it's important to test it to make sure the distances and the jumps and everything is well placed. To do that, we go to the mod exporter and use, for example, your mod name, test 1. The rest is not important to put anything. And to make the export faster, let's gonna use only the platform we are gonna use. In my case, Windows. The export folder path should be the mod folder inside the Senders installation folder. You might want to make a shortcut to that mod folder for easily work with your exported maps. Once we put the export path correctly, let's click export. When the export finishes, we can find the map inside the mod section in the game. Step 8. Finish your map until you're happy. So my tip here is to work on your map until you're happy with it. And work a lot of hours making sure everything looks good and writes well. Remember, if you enjoy playing it, others can enjoy as well. Step 9. Preparing media for mod.io. We will need a few things here. we will need a thumbnail, screenshots of your map, a description of it, of course. You might as well include people who helped you through the process. Make a zip file of your map. And of course, create an account on mod.io. Now, to upload your mod to mod.io, just go to your profile, mods, and add mod. And then you need to fill everything in here. It's really easy to do. And that's it. You're gonna have your mod uploaded for everyone to enjoy. Step 10, share your experience. Remember that the Sanders community is one of the most friendly communities out there. Don't hesitate to ask help from other creators and players. You will find a link to the Sanders official server on Discord in the descriptions, and another useful links that might help you with your modding. So this is everything for me to tell you, and thanks for watching the video. Hope you liked it, and again, if you did, please leave a like, put a comment or any questions you have, and subscribe if you wanna see some more amazing The Sanders content and other games as well. Thank you again, see ya!